Not only am I presumed to be innocent, I am innocent.
I ask all of you to wait and hear the truth before you label or condemn me. Don't treat me like a criminal, because I am innocent.
I love my community, and I have great faith in our justice system. Please keep an open mind and let me have my day in court. I deserve a fair trial like every other American citizen. I will be acquitted and vindicated when the truth is told. Thank you.
It's all up to the jury now. Deliberations in the Michael Jackson trial have finally...
The jury arrived here about 45 minutes ago. They've been deliberating now for the past 35 minutes. This is the first full day, of course, of deliberations.
Approaching 3.5 hours of jury deliberations here.
You know, we're approaching 6 hours in that jury room, our unofficial count of how long the jury has been in that room.
And we are all on standby waiting for word. We know that the jurors have sent out a note asking the judge a question. We don't know what it is, trying to see if we can find that out.
The jury continuing their deliberations, coming up on a little bit past 9.5 hours now over the span of 3 days.
So I think they might be struggling in there a little bit, but there's a sense that tomorrow could be a day when they might break through a logjam.
12 hours, 45 minutes and counting. Okay.
Jurors have just completed their second full day of deliberation. 14 hours.
I can tell you that the jury has indeed resumed their deliberations.
It's day three in deliberations of the Michael Jackson trial.
Fourth day of jury deliberations, the third full day.
Night. The jury's still in jury deliberations.
Everybody's on pins and needles. Everybody's waiting for the verdict. And, you know, you can't think about anything else when you're waiting for a jury. Just where's the jury?
Today is day five of deliberations. Jurors will only go half a day.
They've been at it for a total of 22 hours, spread over 5 days without reaching a verdict.
Could the jury want to put this to rest before the big weekend?
The jury's been deliberating almost 24 hours. Still no verdict, but it is Friday.
A full week after getting the case, the jury has yet to reach a verdict. They went home for the weekend. Deliberations pick up again on Monday.
The jury wrapped up its first full week of deliberations. They went home.
Now, so far, the jury has spent 28 hours here at the courthouse without reaching a verdict.
Jury deliberations, day 7, underway in Michael Jackson's child molestation case. Reported just a few moments ago that they arrived a bit early today at about 8:15 your time, which is about 11:15 here.
I put a tie on today because I thought maybe we're having a verdict.
On Friday, they began to hear a readback of the
verdict.
Key.
Verdict. Verdict. Verdict.
The clock is now ticking. It is less than 1 hour. We are supposed to find out the fate of
the
Michael
jury
Jackson.
Has reached a verdict in that Santa Maria courthouse.
And now the jury in the Michael Jackson case has reached a verdict. Within the hour, we will know what
that
verdict
kid
is.
Who happens to come from a family that has pursued questionable litigation against JCPenney, that is involved in welfare fraud, a family.
In this case, really had reasonable doubt written all over them. Remember, Tom Mesro, in his closing argument, pointed out a number of times where there were inconsistent statements from the mother, the brother, the accuser himself,
and the sister. We play this back. If there's a not guilty verdict, and you can all have the last laugh. What about I may have to eat crow later, but I'm going to go out there guilty on the molestation counts. Everything else after that, gravy for the
defense. Did a very good job of casting doubt on this family, showing the pattern of shaking people down, potentially making up lies in order to get money.
About 30 minutes or so from now, give or take a few minutes, the verdict will be in. Michael Jackson, guilty or not guilty?
And that verdict will be read live.
The court
court has said a verdict has been reached. It will be read at 4:30.
The biggest mistake they made was Debbie Rowe was calling the wife and expecting her to come out with these bombshells about what an abusive guy he was, or, you know, he was questionable what he would do with young boys. And boy, did that just fall flat on their face.
8 minutes, 30 seconds. Countdown to
what
justice.
I think they should do is I think they should acquit. I don't think the case was made.
A guilty verdict.
This was a very orderly deliberation. This is one of those deliberations that I guarantee you they were right near a decision now on Friday.
We've just been notified that there are some 50 or 60 police officers on the other side of the barrier, which is where the fans.
That's even a cop on a bike, a bike cop. We are expecting the verdict to be announced around 4:45. That's in about 20 minutes.
Thomas Mesereau, in his close, used that tape as well and encouraged jurors to go and watch the tape and look for inconsistencies.
You can see right now behind me, Shepard, if you can see, they're allowing everybody to go inside the courtroom. So that gives us a heads up. It's kind of a warning that we are getting very close.
And 36 judges had tried cases where prior acts were admitted. Of those 36, 35 resulted in conviction.
And I will eat crow if they don't get this guy on
Michael
something.
Jackson expected to arrive in about 15 minutes or so, and then he'll have to come into court.
I want to let you know Michael Jackson is 10 minutes away from this courthouse.
And there is Tom Mesereau, as he often did during the trial, waiting to receive the motorcade carrying his client, Michael
Tom
Jackson.
Tom Mesereau, the defense attorney, is now walking into the courthouse with his assistant.
I think there's going to be a conviction on the molestation, Kimmy.
I think you're right, and we may be having crow pie together. He's going to be acquitted on the molestation.
Yeah, go ahead.
Shep, can I jump in here? We just got a five-minute warning now for the verdict. And that, by the way, is Tom Snedden, who just walked in the courthouse. He is, of course, surrounded by his attorneys, Ron Zonin and Gordon Auchincloss. 5 minutes now, we're told they'll
read.
Did you
see how confident Tom Snedden walked in that courtroom?
I absolutely think they're going to convict on child molestation.
Tom Snedden just looked like the cock of the walk. And
as soon as possible. The motorcade right now is only about a block away. They're going to be making a left-hand turn here and then entering the courthouse area. So we're about a minute away or less. They're going to turn here and then take a right into the courthouse. And they have four SUVs. Presumably a good portion of the Jackson family will be with Michael Jackson as he steps out and walks in to hear his fate.
And I can hear the crowd really start to roar for Michael Jackson as he arrives here.
And step out the body cards and
the sound from what may be going on. And there he is, Michael Jackson, being escorted inside, surrounded by his father and other family members. His bodyguards are there as well. Michael Jackson walking in, Thomas Mesereau with the white hair, his criminal defense attorney, his lead attorney, as they go inside. Let's listen a little bit longer. Ted Rollins, we've seen this happen on so many different occasions during the course of these 14 weeks of this trial. It's a lot different, though, today.
Oh, yeah, and, you know, it may not seem that way. The pictures, they seem the same, but I can tell you at the courthouse, it is night and day. The emotion, just watching him get out, there's Jermaine Jackson.
Drew, it has been your insistence and contention that Michael Jackson is not a guilty man here. Can you still hold it?
Absolutely. I do not believe that Michael Jackson is guilty.
Well, it's eight women and four men, largely middle class, no African Americans on the jury, which has drawn some notice.
At the council table waiting, but the jurors have not yet been brought into the courtroom. And we just saw in that live shot that one of the courtroom doors just closed.
Very calm sense of quiet outside the courthouse where I could barely hear myself a few minutes ago. Now I can hear a pin drop for a block away. There is nobody talking. Everybody is waiting for this audio feed.
Every broadcast television network in all of the country to interrupt its afternoon program to bring you the reading of the verdict against Michael Jackson.
This is a moment in legal history.
Tom Snedden has always been confident. Tom Snedden was confident in 93. Tom Snedden was as confident, and if I may be so bold to quote others who were observing at the time,
I'm being told the jury is now coming in. The judge wanted the alternates to be here as well, four men and four women that sat through the trial. The alternates are coming in with the 12 panelists, and presumably now within the minute we should start to hear this audio feed.
It's a little bit too long for an acquittal. It's not quite long enough for a hung jury. I don't think it's quite long enough for an outright acquittal. I think there's no question we're going to see convictions
here. The judge
is
on the bench. He's got a radio. And the verdict has now been handed to the judge.
The judge is reviewing the jury ballots as we speak.
The jurors are, to an individual, it's in my understanding, staring at the judge in this case. They're not looking around the room, not looking at each other. They're not looking at the defendant.
When the
jury stares at the judge, it's not an innocent.
They do not want to look at the defendant that they have just convicted.
Bob Shapiro, here we go. Here's the audio. Let's listen.
Of the courtroom clerk reading the verdicts. It's coming in now. Momentarily, we go there live.
And now the courtroom.
Superior Court of the State of California for the County of Santa Barbara, Santa Maria Division. The people of the State of California, plaintiff versus Michael Joe Jackson, defendant. Case number 1133603. Count one, verdict. We, the jury in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of conspiracy as charged in count one of the indictment, dated June 13, 2005, for person number 80. Count two, verdict. We, the jury in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of a lewd act upon a minor child as charged in count two of the indictment, dated June 13, 2005, for person number 80. Count three, verdict. We, the jury in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of a lewd act upon a minor child as charged in count three of the indictment, dated June 13, 2005, for person number 80. Count four, verdict. We, the jury in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of lewd act upon a minor child as charged in count four of the indictment, dated June 10th, 2005, for person number 80. Count five, verdict. We, the jury in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of a lewd act upon a minor child as charged in count five of the indictment, dated June 10th, 2005, for person number 80. Count six, verdict. We, the jury in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of attempting to commit a lewd act upon a minor child as charged in count six of the indictment, dated June 13, 2005, for person number 80. Count seven, verdict. We, the jury in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of administering an intoxicating agent to assist in the commission of a felony as charged in count seven of the indictment, dated June 13, 2005, for person number 80. Count seven, verdict, lesser offense. We, the jury in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of providing alcoholic beverages to persons under the age of 21, a lesser included offense of that charge in count seven of the indictment, dated June 13, 2005, for person number 80. Count eight, verdict. We, the jury in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of administering an intoxicating agent to assist in the commission of a felony as charged in count 8 of the indictment, dated June 13, 2005, for person number 80. Count 8 verdict, lesser offense. We, the jury, in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of providing alcoholic beverages to persons under the age of 21, a lesser included offense that charged in count 8 of the indictment, dated June 13, 2005, for person number 80. Count 9 verdict. We, the jury, in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of administering an intoxicating agent to assist in the commission of a felony as charged in count 9 of the indictment, dated June 10, 2005, for person number 80. Count 9 verdict, lesser offense. We, the jury, in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of providing alcoholic beverages to persons under the age of 21, a lesser included offense of that charge in count 9 of the indictment, dated June 10, 2005, for person number 80. Count 10, verdict. We, the jury, in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of administering an intoxicating agent to assist in the commission of a felony as charged in count 10 of the indictment, dated June 10, 2005, for person number 80. Count 10, verdict, lesser offense. We, the jury, in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of providing alcoholic beverages to persons under the age of 21, a lesser included offense of that charge in count 10 of the indictment, dated June 10, 2005, for person number 80.
That completes the reading of the verdicts. I'm now going to go off here.
Michael Jackson not guilty of child molestation. Michael Jackson not guilty of handing alcohol to a minor. Michael Jackson not guilty on every single count.
And there it is, all 10 counts, not guilty on all 10 counts. Michael Jackson will be walking out of this courtroom a free man, slam dunk against the prosecution. Jeffrey,
too. Michael Jackson not guilty on all counts.
A Santa Maria jury finds Michael Jackson not guilty on each and every charge he faced. No compromises, no hung jury.
Did Michael Jackson now officially not guilty?
And 14 times, a total of 14 times for the 10 counts and four lesser included offenses, the words not guilty were uttered.
Michael Jackson is a free man. He is acquitted on every count. Jane Secker.
This is the end of the nightmare for Michael Jackson.
It is an absolute and complete victory for Michael Jackson. Utter humiliation and defeat for Thomas Snedden, the district attorney.
Not guilty on all counts.
It is a devastating defeat for the prosecution in this case. Tom Snedden and company not guilty on each of the 10 charges.
A free man fully vindicated by this jury in Santa Maria.
And a clear and decisive unanimous win for Michael Jackson.
It was a stunning and comprehensive defeat for Santa Barbara's District Attorney Tom
Snedden.
An innocent man, the $4 million trial is over, and Michael Jackson is free.
This was a unanimous decision, not guilty on every single charge.
141 witnesses, 60 days of testimony, and 32 hours of jury deliberations, and it all boiled down to just two words, not guilty.
The right verdict based on the evidence that was presented.
Not guilty, not guilty, not guilty, not guilty on all of the 10 counts, including the four lesser counts on the alcohol charges.
It's not guilty on all counts, I'm sure.
Michael Jackson acquitted on 10 counts tonight.
American Michael Jackson.
The jury found Jackson not guilty on all 10 charges against him.
Not guilty, not guilty, not guilty, 10 times. We heard it, not guilty.
The defense has won here.
A clear and decisive unanimous win for Michael Jackson against these charges.
It
was a clean sweep. Not guilty of child molestation, but also not guilty of conspiracy and not guilty on any alcohol charges. About the verdicts.
Justice was done. The man's innocent. He always was.
Not guilty on all counts. Back home at Neverland, a free man tonight.
Stunning, absolute victory for Michael Jackson and a crushing, humiliating defeat for the prosecutor who spent a decade trying to convict him.
He suffered one of the most stinging defeats in celebrity trial history.
Truly a verdict heard round the world.
I'm having a crow sandwich right now. It doesn't taste very good.
They were on the edge of their seats as Jackson was found not guilty.
Michael Jackson walks away a free man, acquitted on all counts in his child molestation trial.
He is not guilty. 10 times he's not guilty. So
look like a pro-prosecution jury. And if this jury had no doubt, there is none of us should have any doubt whatsoever.
Hats off to this jury. They've served well. I think the press conference made very clear what a difficult burden this was for them and how very seriously they took their responsibility.
He was brought up, I think, in an environment where he was taught to lie.
We're red. Here's a picture of him sort of bolting. There he is right there in the middle of the screen. He was basically one of the first to get out of there. This is not a good day, Ted, for him.
No, you can really see the grim faces, can't you, on the prosecution team?
Yeah,
so obviously we're disappointed in the verdict, but...
But we spent a lot of time really seriously studying the evidence and looking at the testimony and the jury instructions.
Is that it's a bad day for the prosecution.
And this case was a lot less effective in front of a jury than it was when selected reporters were given salacious tidbits over the past several years.
This is an important day in Michael Jackson's life. He hugged his mother.
Right.
He hugged his father. He gave all of his brothers and sisters a kiss. And he saw his children, who are the most important thing in the world.
We heard all the not guilty, not guilty, not guilty.
We saw these witnesses. For the most part, yeah, they were horrific witnesses, in my opinion. Less than credible, less than truthful, a lot of baggage. They seemed not prepared. The prosecution stumbled through most of their presentation. It was just a case not well thought of.
Leaving the courtroom where the judge has now dismissed the jury. Go ahead, Bob.
Tom Stenton did not have a case, and yet he prosecuted Michael Jackson. Had it been anyone else, Michael Jackson or that other person would not have been in court.
Your bail is exonerated, and you're released.
Thank you.
A vested interest in this case. Tom Stenton didn't have a personal stake in this case when he's scaling stairs of the private investigator Bradley Miller's office to determine the layout. That stuff investigators don't like. I mean... hired nine experts at the county's expense, nine experts just on the fingerprints alone.
Family, let's listen in to see if we can hear anything.
Jury that five other boys have been molested, and you should believe us when we say that, and three of those boys get up for the defense, come into the courtroom, look the jury in the eye and say, never happened to me, and by the way, he never asked me, Mr. Stenton, if it even happened. You call a witness like Debbie Rowe and you promise the jury hook, line, and sinker what she's going to deliver, and boom, she's an atomic bomb. She's a, you know.
He's inside his SUV now. His supporters, his family members hugging each other. Michael Jackson blew a kiss or two to his fans. He could hear the cheering as he was walking out. Thomas Mesereau, his attorney, staying behind together with his legal team. Michael Jackson, not guilty, all 10 counts, all 10 counts that were brought against
him. Because this is a guy who put out 100 search warrants against Michael Jackson. That's
clearly
overkill.
Didn't make a statement on this particular occasion. Perhaps he'll be making a statement once he returns to his Neverland Ranch, another 45-minute or so drive from here.
He overtried the case. He spent too much time sliming Michael Jackson, bringing in his finances. What the hell does the financial situation have to do with child molestation?
These black vehicles that have borne him to and from this court these last 4 months. A pat on the back from Thomas Mesereau. And the Jackson car is leaving court.
Obviously, we're disappointed by the outcome, but...
Well, look, he lost, and he...
Her testimony, a lot of the parts of her testimony, I wanted to just break out laughing, but I couldn't.
They put on witnesses who were lacking in credibility. They did everything they could to try and hold them up in ways that just didn't make any sense. A lot of their theories and arguments made no sense, and they didn't have a case. And Michael Jackson's innocent.
I thought the defense presented a lot stronger case. They followed through and everything. They showed us all the evidence that they would bring forth. They would show us everything that we needed
to see. The bottom line here is the jury did not believe the accuser and the accuser's family. They were, quite frankly, an unbelievable bunch.
The one thing I want to mention about Tom Snedden is that if he thinks that this case is not going to be the legacy that he leaves when he leaves office, he's deluding himself.
I cannot tell you how wonderful it feels, and I know that Michael is just kissing his mom, his dad, his brothers, his sisters. Michael, congratulations, you are my man.
I just liked it intensely when she snapped her fingers at us. That's when I thought, don't snap your fingers at me, lady.
What a party out here, going on 5 hours now. In fact, the papers came out not too long ago. They've been passing them out to all the fans. You can hear the music behind.
I thought that we had really destroyed their case very effectively on cross-examination, and I thought we had called a lot of very effective witnesses in our case. And I thought when you put that whole package together, they were going to have trouble.
The problem in this case was the mother and the complaining witness. They were both self-admitted liars.
Maybe we're just looking for explanations in the wrong places. I don't know.
Jury, despite being inundated by media, despite the fact they were not sequestered, despite the fact there were questionable rulings by the judge, this jury said the evidence wasn't there and they acquitted him. I think this is good for America.
Would it be safe to say you did not believe him?
Yes, we had a hard time believing.
We, as a country, have to understand that our system presumes someone innocent until proven guilty, and that proof was not made here.
I can't say there was anything that convinced me to say guilty ever throughout the whole trial.
I'm just flabbergasted and very happy for Michael. Not only did he get 10 not guilties today, but this should take care of all the doubt and the black cloud that has been over him. And this, 1108? That vindicates him from all of this stuff.
They saw the color drain from your face, both for you, Mr. Snedden, and you, Mr. Zonin.
We had to look at him as just like any other individual, not just as a celebrity.
If you really looked at the evidence in the case, they had nothing. They had absolutely nothing. And networks like Court TV did their best to spin a conviction.
I had no doubt whatsoever Michael will be acquitted on all the charges. Neither did Michael from the very beginning.
This is nothing. This is history. It's over with. Let's just let it go.
The jury acquitted Michael. We're still talking about all of the allegations as if they, in fact, were proven.
Quote, thank God Michael is vindicated for all time. Now maybe people will leave him alone.
I wouldn't want any of my children to lie for their own gain.
I think their case had too many problems with it because it wasn't true.
I felt that he was vindicated, you know. The man is not a child molester.
I think the jury did a very good job in terms of taking this very seriously, taking a lot of notes, evaluating the evidence, leaving no stone unturned. Like or not like their decision, these were honorable people.
Michael Jackson is not just free on bail. Michael Jackson is free now that he's been acquitted on all of 10 of the counts.
The accuser's mother could not be believed, and her kids, who accused Jackson of child molestation, could not be trusted either.
Jackson motorcade is pulling up
along a gauntlet, if you will, of Jackson supporters who gathered outside his Neverland Ranch. He is arriving at the entrance to that sprawling 3,000-acre facility, which includes, of course, the amusement park and the homes. It is an extraordinarily large property,
You know, when I saw the DA, Tom Snedden, today, the ultimate loser, I mean, you really can't lose more than
he
did today.
My past history of Mr. Jackson had absolutely, unequivocally, nothing to do with our evaluation of this particular
case. We've indicated and cleared Michael Jackson completely. He was acquitted of all felony counts and all misdemeanor counts. They got nothing.
And acquitted of all the charges against him.
He's someone else, just like anyone else, who deserves a fair trial.
You just can't build a case on a foundation as weak as these. These witnesses lacked utter credibility. I think it's a great day for the system. I think the system worked, and reasonable doubt means something, and these jurors understood that. I have a lot of faith in the system.
All right, well,
this is the moment those fans have waited for. They have come to this courthouse.
And passing these out to the people that have assembled here, and people are still coming. Not too much of a surprise. The party has begun here.
So there was a lot of discrepancies in his testimony, and it didn't quite coincide with what he had said.
So a lot of this was spin by the prosecution because they wanted to try and convict him through spin. They had nothing to deal with in the courtroom.
I think that this was a smart jury. I think that they were diligent and wanting to do a good job.
This was a grifter family with a record that was so checkered. It was pathetic. Right. It was sickening. This was a setup. It never would have been brought if it was in any other county. Tom Snedden has had this grudge for 13 years.
I talked with Tom Mesereau, who told me that he was proud to have defended Michael Jackson, that Jackson was innocent all along, and he was just proud to prove
it. Come down here and check my life. See what I've been doing the last 10 years.
The decision is whether to present this piece of garbage called the People versus Michael Jackson to a grand jury. It was presented, and the state paid the price.
We had a closet full of evidence. There was nothing in that closet that was able to convince any of us of the alleged crimes.
The factual inaccuracies, the obvious bias among people like Court TV, who I felt was really an arm of the prosecution through this case. It was very amateurish and very unprofessional and very disturbing.
And he failed. Tom Snedden should be impeached. Tom Snedden has wasted. He has squandered the money of the people. How many real criminals have gotten off during the time that he has been after Michael Jackson and this witch? How many violent felons have gotten off?
You heard yesterday the words that no prosecutor ever wants to hear, and you heard them 10 times.
Uh-huh.
Not guilty, not guilty.
Uh-huh.
You wake up to this headline this morning.
Nothing. I went in there with the courage to convict a celebrity because I really believe in doing what's right. And witness after witness, I was more convinced of the innocence because of the motivations of financial gain and revenge. It was just amazing the way it was laid out.
Australia at one point in the mid-90s to try and find an alleged victim, and the person said, take a hike, get out of here, you know.
Mm-hmm.
He had a website at the sheriff's department to try and see if he could find witnesses to build a case. It was like an open casting call on Michael Jackson. And the best they could come up with was this family that we thoroughly discredited from A to Z.
I mean, Nasser Grace, he's guilty. O'Reilly, he's guilty. Those who are competing for making the newsroom case for Michael determined by Empress or innuendo by
he jurors, race, no race, it doesn't matter. They all seem to do the right job. Once again, that's proven out.
This is a non-African-American jury.
Right.
No one can look back and say that this was another O.J. racially motivated verdict.
He's very, very honorable, decent person, and I thoroughly enjoyed representing him, and I consider him a friend.
Michael, Joseph, Catherine, and the family, and Tom Mesereau and his staff, and I, and a lot of other people, believed from day one that Michael would be acquitted across the board.
I was convinced all along the jury would find him not guilty. I thought the prosecution's case was really ridiculous, and I thought they went to every absurd length they could to try and make something out of nothing.
She looked at me and snapped her fingers a few times, and she says, you know how our culture is, and winks at me. I thought, no, that's not the way our culture is.
She is. The cars are now lined up a mile down this road. People are walking in. They're running in. We've seen flowers
this
delivered.
This is a case that smelled bad, and if it smells like you-know-what, then it is you-know-what, and that's what the jury said.
Take Court TV, for example. In this particular case, in my opinion, they became a tabloid. They had their own agenda. They misstated the facts. They didn't understand the significance of what was going on in the courtroom, and that's why their major critics were stunned by the verdict.
Justice has finally been served, and Mike's a free man.
I could not be more impressed with this jury. Clearly, they did follow the judge's instructions.
He thought it happened three times. No, it happened four times. And then, I think it happened once in the library, so that would have been five times. And then at the end of it, he says, no, he really never touched me at all.
The jurors were extremely conscientious. I thought they were thoughtful, measured in their approach. I mean, in many ways, they're the model jury system. And this is one occasion when I personally felt I was glad the world was watching to see how hard these jurors
Santa Maria Times, an extra. Not guilty on all counts. Newsday, Michael Moonwalk. Michael Jackson acquitted child molestation, other charges. Jurors, case wasn't there. You saw it in Boston earlier. Herald, like this headline, too. Beat it. Chicago Sun-Times, straight-ahead headline, not guilty.
You know, it'd be nice if every client was as nice and comfortable to deal with as Michael Jackson. Believe me, he's a very down-to-earth, nice, kind-hearted person.
He turned, he hugged each of his attorneys. At that time, and of course his family at that point, were all hugging
See,
each other.
Michael is free. He's free like a bird, and he's always been innocent of all this.
I'm ecstatic. It has been pure hell, Anderson. You just would not believe.
He's a very, very kind, extremely sensitive, intuitive, very generous individual.
We had a complainant here who went and consulted with two civil attorneys, the psychiatrist retained by the civil attorneys before he ever went to the police.
She was just downright rude to us, as far as I'm concerned, and I think she set her son up. I think she's probably the poorest excuse for a mother I've ever known.
You had a family that had made previous grabs for money, making allegations of sexual abuse that were proved to be false in the past.
The proof wasn't there, and I can't say I believe he's a child molester. The proof wasn't there to prove it to me.
The jury was just not going to buy it. The case didn't smell good, and I didn't like the fact that it was brought in the first place.
They're so happy. They're so relieved. They're feeling great.
And our plan was to be extremely aggressive and put them on the defensive as quickly as possible, and I think we achieved that. So we had a lot of good days in this trial, particularly in their case and particularly in our case.
And when they said not guilty for all 10 counts, I felt like the world had been lifted off my shoulders. I was crying all while they were with tears of joy, of course.
Lost the case. This was a family. I sat through this trial. This was a family that crumbled under cross-examination.
They had lied before under oath. They were welfare cheats. They had already exonerated.
If, in my opinion, the prosecution had evaluated the evidence they had before they ran amok, perhaps this would never have cost the taxpayers of Santa Barbara so much money.
Big headlines today. Not guilty on all counts.
The media was really having him arrested and executed, already handcuffed already, and say you're guilty for weeks and weeks.
First
now.
Of all, there weren't 100 search warrants in this case.
I mean, he always was a very straightforward, honest, down-to-earth person to deal with. And the Michael Jackson that I know doesn't even come close to the Michael Jackson they tried to portray.
Second of all, we didn't spend a ton of money.
I'll tell you what celebrity injustice was in this case. It was sending 70 sheriffs to raid Michael Jackson's home in a search. It was putting more experts, more sheriffs, and more investigators on this case than they do with serial killers. That's what I call celebrity injustice.
I have given this one passing thought once that case ended in 1993 and 94. You're not in touch with reality. I never said one word after that press conference, ever, in 10 years.
person. And yes, he's been a target for many years. He's been maligned. He's been scandalized. But he's also one of the world's greatest artists and one of the world's greatest talents and also one of the world's greatest humanitarians. And Michael has all the tools and the skills and the support to recover and go forward and do very well.
This is the bitter pill you're going to have to swallow, Nancy. This is the reality, not the reality you have created for the last year. Michael Jackson is not guilty. Let him live his life in peace and stop trying to retry the case, and that's what you're doing.
You know what? You're right. Replay this back if there's a not guilty verdict, and you can all have the last laugh. Not guilty. Not guilty.
Replay this back.
Replay this back, and you can all have the last laugh.
The last laugh. The last laugh. The last laugh. The last laugh. The last
and
laugh.
And I will eat crow. I may have to eat crow later.
And we may be having crow pie together.
Well, I'm having a crow sandwich right now. It doesn't taste very good.
Mr. Jackson was not only not guilty, he was completely innocent of any of these allegations.
Many victims must have been slaughtered in vain across the land. And how many struggles must have been before we choose to live the prophet's plan? Everybody sing.
Every day create your history. Every path you take, you're leaving your legacy. Every soldier dies in his glory. Every legend tells of conquest and liberty.
Don't let no one get you down. Keep moving on higher ground. Keep flying until you are the king of the kill. No force of nature can break your will to self-motivate. She said this face that you see is destined for history. How many people have to cry the song of pain and grief across the land? And how many children have to die before we stand to lend a healing hand? Everybody sing.
Every day create your history. Every path you take, you're leaving your legacy. Every soldier dies in his glory. Every legend tells of conquest and liberty. Every day create your history. Every page you turn, you're writing your legacy.
Replay this back if there's a not guilty verdict, and you can all have the last laugh.
Ha 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 ha